Okay, this is take two. I don't mind the messiness of my house. My wife's a hoarder. Anyway, this is the crutch that I want reproduced. This is the last pair of crutches you guys made for me. You can see the leather portion of this crutch is a little bit worn out, and it's actually been recycled from an older set of crutches, so I can understand why it's going out. No reflection on you guys' work. And that's basically the bottom portion of a crutch. It's the traditional crutch that goes up under your arm. The only difference is, of course, the leather band we have here. You guys affixed it to cut off the top portion, the traditional top portion of a crutch, and put a couple of rivets in there and attach this leather band, thus making them the famed Canadian style crutches. Now those are the ones that you produced for me a couple of months ago. These are the ones that I had before. This is one of the ones I had before. As you can see, it's the same type crutch, different cuff on the top, slightly different in that it's a different color, and the way it was affixed to the crutch is a little different. And the reason it's different is because obviously the creative people there were able to convert a piece from a from what I've told was a wheelchair. This little black portion here, what they did was took it off a wheelchair to use it as a cap for this metal post so I wouldn't scratch up my wall and my hands as I walk by or put my hand through the crutch. And they affixed both sides with a couple of rivets. And I want the crutches. You should have the measurements for each crutch. The only thing is the I love the measurements. The only thing is for the last set of crutches you guys made for me, the two posts that go at the top, one of them was a little too narrow. So let me see if I can hold this and do it at the same time. You see my fist almost has a squeeze in it from both sides. Now that's not a problem in the summertime. Now why would you ask if weather had anything to do with it? Weather has something to do with it because you see I have a rather thin kind of sweatshirt on. Now if it's 20 degrees below zero outside and I'm wearing a thick coat and I had to quickly put my arm through here, the thick coat is obviously going to be a little difficult to put my arm through there, especially if I want to get out of the car quick and run into the house. So if it's possible, and I know you may have some restrictions as far as a handrest is concerned, if it's possible, make the two posts a little bit wider than they are here. And I'm not quite sure whether it was bent after I got it or what, but these posts at the top are a little bit too close, so you can kind of widen those out. Anyway, hopefully that wasn't too long a video, and I'll try to put some bells and whistles on this so you can be entertained with it. All right, if you have any questions, my name is Darryl Jennings, and I can be reached on this phone at 313-617-4685. Thanks.